Hi everyone, my name is Matthias Bäuerlein and I'm here at the Separate Sound and Groove Studios in Nürnberg. Today I want to talk about drum sound. Right now I finished a drum session where I've recorded 10 songs and my intern Niklas and me thought it would be cool to give you some overview about how I create my drum sound and what's important for me. The first step, the basic sound. When the drums are set up and tuned, I select the cymbals and the snare I want to start with, and we bring all the microphones in place. As a starting point, I just listen to three microphones, one bass drum microphone and the two overheads. These three microphones together should already sound good. But how do I get this? For me, it's important to have a complete picture of the whole drum kit with the two overheads. Both overheads should have the same distance to the snare drum. So I measure the distance from the center point of the snare to the overheads. Now it's about 98 centimeters, but it can vary depending on how open or dry I want it to sound. I either reduce or increase the distance of the mics, so I get different results. So, this is basically my starting point. No matter if it's narrower or wider, with the right mic I focus more on getting these toms and with the left one we focus on getting more the snare. Please notice there are delay times which makes the stereophony actually what it is, so that this tom is closer to this microphone and because the mics are panned hard left and right, this one will appear more on the left side and this one will appear more on the right side. The same with the cymbals, while the snare should stay in the middle. Now I add the bass drum mic and listen to these three mics and on this point the sound has to work already. Second, the direct signals. Direct signals are the snare, toms, hi-hat, snare bottom, and also the mic under the right cymbal. I don't need it very often, but sometimes it's quite helpful when the right cymbal needs a little more body. Now I start listening to the direct signals. Therefore, I just listen to the direct mic on my in-ears and play with the position. If I want more body or if I want more attack, I either align the microphone more to the center of the drum or maybe more to the rim. The same with the toms. It's very important to check if the face fits with the overheads. I often just have to switch the face of the overheads and everything's fine. Third and last step, the room miking. For this step, I have one microphone standing in our corridor. It's a mono signal, it's often a C414 that I set up to Omni. And I use this very often in my mixes because it produces a great room sound even in this small corridor. And in this special case, MS miking setup that points to the drum set. This point can varying. Sometimes I put microphones near the walls when I want to catch some early reflections. Long story short, this last point can be very different depending on what I need from the room, and I'm often very creative when it comes to miking the room. So, that's it. This is how I mostly set up my drum sound. For me, it's a very creative process how and where I position the mics. And it's very big fun for me to build a drum sound from the scratch. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And if you have any questions, please write them down in the comment section below. I'd be very happy to hear your feedback. Bye bye.